Ah yes, the Fulham Boys School. Built on the Christian faith, geared towards boys and nurturing enterprise. Famous for the can-do attitude, showing those standards, and Mr. Lane's slowly receding hairline? I actually mean striving to be one of the very best schools in this country, state or private, in the next few years. We're finally on a new site, as you can see shown here. High-tech state-of-the-art facilities, brilliant sports equipment, scrumptious lunches, and of course, quite a few stairs. However, if you're feeling a bit tired, you can always take the lift. We haven't always been here. In fact, we haven't always been a school. 10 years ago, the Fulham Boys School didn't even exist. So how did it come about? Well, we're about to find out. Welcome to a brief history of the Fulham Boys School. Let's take it back to 2014, and the school, after many years of hard work, is on the brink of opening. Here's Chairman of Governors, Alex Wade, to explain a little more.
I have three boys, so this started from self-interest more than anything else, that I think I faced the same choices that so many people face in Fulham. It was actually my wife who said to me, well, it's not just a choice of paying or moving. A third option might be we set up our own school. First thing I did, I had a meeting with our MP, Greg Hands, and he was incredibly supportive, and that meant that I then took the next step and I had a meeting with the local authority.
At Fulham Boys School, we plan to have the highest standards of uniform, of attendance, of punctuality, of behaviour, and so that all boys know exactly what is expected of them.
So many people we spoke to were enthused by the idea and wanted to get on board. And from those initial discussion came our original founding group of 10 astounding individuals who, out of sheer determination and hard work, have made this school a reality.
It's making these boys realise and understand it's not just about what they do in the classroom, but all these things put together will help them be worldwide citizens and make a real difference to their communities, their families and the world they live in.
But everything wasn't as it seemed, and quicker than anyone could say, the school received a stunning blow.
The Education Secretary, Michael Gove, has been criticised over his flagship schools policy. Fulham Boys was due to open in September, but problems with suitable premises means around 100 pupils have now been left with no school place for the next academic year.
2 days ago, I was advised by the Department of Education that they had taken the decision to defer the opening of our school.
Devastated. I'm gutted. We're going to fight until it stops and we get our school back.
These are people with a can-do attitude. That's the kind of school we want.
Hi there, Boris. Yes, it's Michael Gove here. Oh, Michael, could you not call it a bit of time? I'm just cooking my steak and oven chips. Sorry to interrupt you, Boris, but it is very urgent. Can you have a chat with the Department for Education about the Fulham Boys School?
I'll see what I can do. I'm off to Peppa Pigwell tomorrow, but I'll see what I can do.
Take that, Boris, old boy. Take it back.
No, well, while you just sort this out, hang on a second.
Why don't you take it back?
Blue.
Hey, three cheers for Boris. The Mayor of London has stepped in at the last minute and made a change. The Fulham Boys School could finally open and begin its own journey. So, that was it. The school had opened. The boys were in, the staff were ready. But what next? The school had a vision to become one of the very best schools in the country, and it was determined to get there. Let's take a look from where the school was to where it is today.
when I wake up in the morning, love. And the sunlight hurts my eyes.
When the school first opened, there were only 80 boys, very small in comparison to a normal year group. There were also only 10 teaching staff at the time of opening. There are now almost 90 staff at the school.
You talking to me?
Likewise, we now have over 800 boys at the school and an almost fully fledged sixth form. So as you can see, a massive growth since we first started. The school began its days, however, at Gibbs Green, a temporary site off the North End Road. Let's take it back there to remember the first ever site. Green was a great temporary site to get the school up and running and to be able to build a foundation. I asked some of the boys what their favourite memory of Gibbs Green was.
My favourite memory is Astra.
Lining up in morning form.
My favourite memory of Gibbs Green is in year 7 on the last day of term when they set off rockets to end the year with a bang.
We had the swings and we would just start swinging all in unison. That was really fun. If you had that experience, it would be amazing.
One of my fondest memories of Gibbs Green was walking between sites from Gibbs Green at Beaumont Avenue. Every day, I don't know why, I'd always smell this weird smell. And by the time I got to my next lesson, I'd always feel really tired. I don't know what it was.
I really liked the playground. You could run around a lot.
I really enjoyed playing football in Astrid.
I really miss the old site.
It's okay, mate, don't worry. We all miss the old site. But with the school quickly growing in size, it needed another home to house the ever-increasing number of boys. In stepped Beaumont Avenue. An old mannequin factory located 2 minutes from Gibbs Green. Mark Cowden and his team worked tirelessly for 7 weeks to get this site ready on time. So much happened here. Lunches in the hall, assemblies, the first lads and dads, the first international food market. It was also the place where we said goodbye to our first cohort of boys that left in year 11. Now, as we're not there anymore, it was hard to get some video footage. But I did get some video footage of the BA reception.
SLT to facilities.
Don't make me angry.
But what about the long-awaited promise of a permanent site?
The academic year started September 2016. We will begin our relocation to our permanent home down towards the south of Fulham.
Ponerme las chanclas y el bañador. Voy a la playa, ya subió la marea.
Yes, the new site did take just a little bit longer than expected.
Smith Academy and the Fulham Boys School. Fifth one, however, needs to move to a new site as soon as possible. Could he give us today an update on progress on moving to the new site?
As he will know, there have been complexities in this particular case.
However, finally, the news everyone had been waiting for.
Mr. Speaker, the fantastic Fulham Boys School will finally open at its new site in September after a 10-year campaign.
And what a site it is.
Hush now, child, and don't
understand you by and by. Just move on up toward your destination, though you may find from time to time complications.